Hey, what's going on, guys? Hey, let's go ahead. Today we're solving quadratics by taking square roots. Okay, this is just another way to solve quadratics, guys. So let's get started. One way to solve a quadratic equation in the form ax squared plus c, all right, equals zero is to isolate the x squared on one side of the equation. All right, now we did a bunch of this. We had the whole radical unit, and in the radical unit, we were solving equations that had the square, and we isolate the square, take the square root on both sides. All right, so remember, when you take the square on both sides, let's say you had x squared equals 4. All right, well, when you take the square root on both sides, you always end up with x equals plus or minus. All right, plus or minus. Anyway, then find the square root of each side. So, well, that's what we did. All right, we said we isolate the x squared, all right, on one side of the equation, then we found the square root on both sides. All right, so first example right here, solve the equation, write the solution as integers if possible, otherwise write them as radical expressions. So again, the variable is isolated, you would take the square root on both sides, and you get x equals plus or minus 2. All right, this one we can solve to get an integer. 2 is an integer. All right, the square root of 4 is 2. All right, over here though, we're going to write it as a radical expression, meaning again we take the square root on both sides because the square is already isolated. All right, and what we get is x equals plus or minus radical 5. There's no square root of 5, so we're going to leave it as a radical expression. Okay, now I got some U tries right here. All right, I'm just going to plug in the answers and you guys give it a shot. Alright, so there is your answers, guys. Y'all work to get those, okay? Down here, man, solve quadratic expression. Solve quadratic equation. It's okay to have a complex solution. Alright, a complex solution meaning, well, here, let's just do an example. So right here, we're going to isolate the variable, x squared. So to do that, first we're going to add 48 on both sides. So when we do that, we got 3x plus 48 on both sides. We have 3x squared equals 48. Then we're going to divide by 3 on both sides. So we have x squared equals 16. And now that we have the x squared isolated, we want to take the square root on both sides. We get x equals plus or minus 4. There's your solution. Over here, we're going to subtract 24 on both sides. Oops, I put 42. Good night. There we go, guys. All right, so you have x squared equals negative 24. Here's where we're going to get our complex solution. All right, so square root both sides. We get x equals plus or minus the square root of negative 24. We're not done here. The reason we're not done here is because remember the whole radical unit we did. Well, there's a perfect square inside of 24. That's a factor. I'm going to factor the radical 24. So I have the square root of negative 1. Right? Remember that becomes I. Then you have the square root of 4 times the square root of 6. 4 times 6 is 24. All right. So now I simplify what I can simplify. The square root of 4 is 2, the square root of negative 1 is I, and the square root of 6 is just square root of 6. So here is our solution set for x. All right, x is this. This is our complex solution. All right. Now, there's a couple of U-tries right here. I'm going to fill in the solutions again, and hopefully they help. All right, here are your answers to the U-try. Please make sure you practice these problems, okay? It's not enough to just go, well, I didn't know how to do it. Like, try to get these answers, okay? If not, let me see your work tomorrow, okay? Yeah, let me see your work. And on the back, guys, this is going to serve as your homework. All right, there's 8 problems, so make sure y'all practice. All right, well, that's it. Peace.